Good morning students, welcome to science video class. We are learning about light, shadow and reflection, and this is part 2 video. Today we are going to learn about shadow and reflection. What are shadows? Shadows are very interesting part to learn because we enjoy shadow. Sometimes we make fun with shadows. Sometimes you may get scared of shadows. When you are walking in the dark, if you see a shadow, then you will be scared. Sometimes accidentally, by looking at your shadow, you will get frightened. Suddenly you have entered into a room. The room is dark. A light is coming from some other distance. Your shadow is fell on the wall like monster. You get scared, right? How a shadow is formed? Let us learn. A shadow is formed when the path of light is blocked by an opaque object. The shadow is always formed in the opposite direction of light. Both solar eclipse and lunar eclipse occur because of these shadows. Let us learn about solar and lunar eclipse. When the moon comes directly between the sun and the earth, the moon blocks the sunlight from reaching the earth and has a shadow on the earth. This is known as solar eclipse. Solar eclipse occurs on a new moon day. Understood, children? When the moon comes directly between the sun and the earth, the moon blocks the sunlight from reaching the earth and casts a shadow on the earth. Understood what is mean by solar eclipse? Okay. When the earth comes directly between the sun and the moon, it blocks the sunlight from reaching the moon and has a shadow on the moon. This is known as lunar eclipse. A lunar eclipse occurs on a full moon day. Understood what is meant by lunar eclipse? When the earth comes directly between the sun and the moon, it blocks the sunlight from reaching the moon and has a shadow on moon. Understood? On a Sunday morning, you are on the way to market to buy something. The sun is shining bright on your face. You see your shadow behind you. The same day evening, you are out to the park to play football. The sunlight falls on your back. You see your shadow on the ground in front of you. After a while, the sun sets. Now there are no more shadows. You are confused and you want to learn when shadows are formed. You are also curious to know the direction in which the shadows are formed. So the shadow is always formed in the opposite direction of light. Understood? Okay. Now I am going to explain the characteristics of shadow. A shadow forms when you block the path of light. Shadow can be seen only on a screen. It need to have a screen. For example, the ground can act as a screen. Walls of the room can act as a screen. Buildings or other surfaces, we can use it as screen. Okay. So shadows can be seen only on a screen. Next, shadows are always formed in the opposite direction to the source of light. Okay. So always the shadow forms on the opposite direction of the light. Then the outline of the shadow matches the outline of the object. Okay. The outline of the shadow matches with the outline of the object. It can be any object. The outline matches with that. Then the brighter the light, the darker the shadow. Usually the shadows, we cannot recognize any color in shadows, right? So it will be in dark shade. The brighter the light, the darker the shadow. Shadows are dark irrespective of the color of the light or the object. So we cannot identify any color in shadows, just it will be dark. Okay, the closer the source of light to an object, the larger the shadow. The farther the source of light from an object, the smaller the shadow. Understood the concept? The source of light is close, the shadows will be larger. The source of light is far away, the shadows will be smaller. Okay, now we are going to learn about mirror and reflection. Already two small topics I have completed. Part 1 I said about light. Now I completed shadow. Now I am going to explain about mirror and reflection. Already you know that light travels in a straight path. Take a torch and switch on. See the light. The light goes in the straight path and hits the wall. It is not bent anywhere. Okay, so to prove I am explaining, light travels in straight line. When the light falls on an object, it can pass through the object and get absorbed by the object and get bounced back or reflected back by the object. Okay, once again let me repeat this. When the light falls on an object, it can pass through the object and get absorbed by the object and get bounced back or reflected back by the object. The objects having polished and shining surfaces reflect most of the light falling on them. A plane mirror is a thin, flat and smooth sheet of glass having a shiny coating on one side. This coating is of silver metal and is protected by a layer of red paint. The silver coating makes the mirror shining on the other side. The shiny surface gives maximum reflection of light. The red paint behind the silvered surface of mirror protects the silver coat, okay, on it. A mirror changes the direction of light. The surface of a mirror is very smooth. Therefore, if a beam of light falls on it, the entire beam is reflected in only one direction. This is called regular reflection. If the surface of the surface of most of the object around are not so smooth, then the ray or beam of light fall on an object with an uneven surface. They get reflected to different directions. This is called irregular reflection of light. We also see reflection of trees, buildings, and other objects in the water of a pond or a lake. Right? Understood, children, about shadows and reflection? Okay. Now, how are images in a plane mirror different from a shadow? I am going to explain. Okay, the length of a shadow changes with the change in the position of the object. If the position of the object changes, the length of the shadow also changes with the respect of source of light. Depends upon the source of light. If there is change in the position of the object, then the length of the shadow also changes. Okay. Then the length of image in a mirror always remains the same. Okay, the length of the image in a mirror. When you stand in front of the mirror, the length of the image remains same. That is equal to the size of the object at all the positions. Understood? Then the shadow is always black in color. Okay, but the image in a mirror shows the same color as the object. If the object is in red color, then the mirror also shows the object in red color. If the object is in blue color, then the image shows us blue color. But the same thing we cannot see in shadows. Always the shadows shows dark color, black color. Okay. Next, the image in a mirror is laterally inverted. There is an interchange of right and left between the object and its image in the mirror. The shadow has no such lateral inversion. If you show any letter on the mirror, you can see the interchange of right and left between the object and its image in a mirror. But this cannot happen in shadow. Shadow has no such lateral inversions. A shadow is formed on a screen. Okay, but the image in a mirror can only be seen and cannot be formed on a screen. If you are standing in front of mirror, then you can see you. Okay, but this shadow, if the, you want your shadow, then there need to be a screen, okay, and then a source of light also need to be there. Then we need to block the path of light, then only your shadow can be seen on the screen. Okay, understood children about shadows and reflection and how are images in a plain mirror different from a shadow? Okay, they have given some activities in your book. Read the book and try to do pinhole camera. It's explained clearly in your book. Okay, and write, define shadow and reflection in your classwork note, and write about the characteristics of a shadow. I have given in PowerPoint presentation. In this video, just go through and write the characteristics of shadow. Already you have written some definitions in your classwork, right? So continue in the same page, leave line and write the subheading with black stick pen. Okay, write shadow and define shadow. Write subheading as reflection and write about reflection. Use blue ink pen to write in the classwork note. Use black stick pen to write the headings. Okay, take homework note and write answer for this question. What are the three necessary conditions to form a shadow? Okay, so what are the three necessary conditions? You should write. Right answer for this question. Okay, so in this lesson, you need to define light, luminous objects, non-luminous objects, transparent, translucent, opaque with examples, and shadow, reflection, and characteristics of a shadow in your classwork note. Okay, these are all the small subheadings you should write in your classwork note. I have given answer in the PPT itself. Just to see and copy down everything clearly in your classwork note. I have given the answers. Okay, don't do any mistakes. Try to write clearly. Understood? The lesson gets over. We have completed fourth lesson, light, shadow, and reflection. Okay, children, stay safely in your home. Bye.